Okay, I'll go. I'll go. You're late.
Oh, I know, I know.
I would love to meet you. Where? When?
So I suppose she's carrying a copy of a book with a flower in it? Not really. Oh, she could be a real dog, man.
I'm only staying 10 minutes. I'm going to say hello, I'm going to have a cup of coffee, and then I'm going to split. That's what I'm going to do. I hope she doesn't have one of those high, squeaky voices like the mice in Cinderella. I hate that. Why am I even doing this? Why am I compelled to even meet her? Why?
And if she turns out even to be as good-looking as a mailbox, I'd be crazy not to turn my life upside down and marry her.
She could be a real dog, but good luck.
Would you go and look for me?
Me?
Yes, just go look through the window and check her out, please.
You're pathetic, man. All right, see what I see. You see her?
Nah.
Oh, wait, yeah. I see a very beautiful girl. Oh, she's fine. She's fine.
Ooh. I knew it.
She's gorgeous.
I knew she would be. I knew it.
But no book. All right. Okay, wait. Wait a minute. All right, look, there's a book with the flowers, so there's gotta be her.
And what does she look like?
Can't see her. Waiter's blocking.
Damn it.
Oh, hold on. He's moving.
Yeah?
Can you see her?
Yeah.
And?
She's very pretty.
She is! I knew she would be! She had to be! She had to be!
You know what? She looked... I mean, she almost has the same coloring as that Kathleen Kelly person.
Kathleen Kelly of the little bookstore.
Well, why not? You said you thought she was attractive.
Absolutely, yes. Why not? Who cares about Kathleen Kelly?
Well, if you don't like Kathleen Kelly, I can tell you right now, you ain't gonna like this girl.
Why not?
Because it is Kathleen Kelly.
Have you?
Please come up.
So, I don't really think that is a good idea because I have a terrible cold.
Yeah.
Listen, I'm stifling and I'm not really awake and I'm taking echinacea and vitamin C. sleeping practically 24 hours a day. I have a temperature. And, I think I'm contagious. So if I would really appreciate it if you would just go away. Just a second.
Hello.
Hello. What are you doing here?
I heard you were sick, and I was worried.
Yeah. You're not gonna believe this.
Oh, let me guess. Through the internet?
Yes.
You've got mail.
Yes.
Those are very powerful words.
Yes.
Well, I'm happy for him.
I've been thinking about this, and I think we should meet.
I'm so tired of getting nowhere, seeing my prayers.
We should meet. And we will meet. But I'm in the middle of a project that needs...
in New York City.
Tweet.
Well, here I am, Lord, knocking at your back door. Ain't it wonderful to be where I've always wanted to be? For the first time I'll breathe free here in New York City.
Some tweaking. A project that needed tweaking. T-W-E-A-K-I-N-G. Tweaking, okay.
That's
right.
What he said.
It sounds to me like he's married. Married three kids.
It's a terrible thing to say. He could not possibly be married.
How do you know? Have you asked him? Have you said, are you married? Have you written to him?
No, I'm not going to ask. No.
I know this is probably a little late to be asking, but are you married?
Am I married? What kind of question is that? How can you ask me that? Don't you know me at all? Oh, wait, I get it. Your friends are telling you the reason we haven't met is that I'm married. Am I right? So he didn't answer the question.
Yes, he did.
He did too.
He did. He nailed me. He knew exactly what I was after, which is just, by the way, exactly like him.
He did not answer the question, did he?
No.
Maybe he's fat. He's fat. He's a fatty.
I don't care about that.
You don't care that he's so fat, he's one of these guys that has to be removed from his house by a crane. You don't care.
That is very unlikely.
Glasses. That he's collected. No.
The number. His address. No. No, he would never do anything that prosaic. Well, the only thing I really care about is the... Well, aside from the married thing and the jail thing.
Of course.
Is the boat thing.
What boat thing?
I can never be with someone who had a boat.
I have a boat.
Oh.
Which clinches it. We'll never be together. How many?
Three.
How about me?
Thank you.
I can never be with someone who likes Joni Mitchell. It's Cloud's illusions, I recall. I really don't know Clouds at all. What does that mean? Is she a pilot? Is she taking flying lessons? It must be a metaphor for something, but I don't know what it is. So how's your book coming?
Well, there's this children's book editor I know from the store, and she's excited to read it when I'm finished.
Yeah?
Who would ever have thought that I would write? I mean, if I hadn't had all this time...
Huh?
You know what?
What?
The truth is that... he was the one who started me thinking about writing.
Mr. 152 felony indictments.
Mr. 152 insights into my soul.
Oh, well, yeah. Oh, no competing with that.
Well, I'll keep on bumping into you.
Yeah.
Hope your mango's ripe.
I think it is.
Hey, you want to bump into me on, say, Saturday around lunchtime?
Yeah.
Over there?
Huh?
Good.
How about meeting Saturday? 4 o'clock. There's a place in Riverside Park at 91st Street where the path curves and there's a garden. Brinkley and I will be waiting.
You're a goose. Today?
Today.
Wow.
I know. In Riverside Park.
Hmm. Well, that would mean he's a West Sider.
Isn't that amazing? Maybe I've seen him and don't even know it.
You could have seen him every day and not know it.
It's very possible.
He could be anybody.
He could
be
anyone.
That guy right there. And those flowers are for you.
Troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops. That's where you find me. Birds fly.